husband and I always wanted a place in the country because it's kind of like, this is your playground. We have a barn full of toys to use to play on our playground. And so it's a place where you can just be wild. I'd kind of like to show you our wild garden, okay? And sort of tell stories about it and the meaning that we can find out there. Some of the engineering work I've done, it sort of has some of the same properties as this approach to architecting and designing myself. This idea of a woman trapped in a man's body, those are adult terms. They don't really frame it quite right. When I was little, now I was smart enough to realize that you really couldn't do certain things, or when you tried to do them, you really did run into trouble. And then being forced into groups and doing things that just don't feel right, being forced to appear to be certain ways. And then, of course, as you get near puberty, the real horror of it all starts to, you know, you start visualizing where this is all headed, you know. And fortunately, I coped a lot by being able to spend a lot of time by myself and just do this, be outside myself, creating, doing, playing, and exploring. You look around, you start to notice a lot of diversity, not just in the trees, but in a lot of the shrubs, flowering plants, and so forth. So a lot of it has to do with when things pioneer in a certain area, maybe making sure that you notice all of the pioneers of that, so that that particular kind of plant gets a chance to grow in an area. Especially in my transition, I think that there was hardly any knowledge in our society even about the existence of transgender identities. And I think, you know, a lot of that's really hit now because those parents who have transgender children are discovering that if they release that valve, if they let the person blossom into who they need to be, they often see just remarkable flourishing of life force. The idea of the wild garden is to move away from cultivated gardens, but some of it's channeled architecturally to support our emotional and social interests. And of course the muskrats over there, they've dug their little holes in the side they can swim in and out of. The pond's got muskrats. And they're creating their own little world, you see, in the same wild garden. I guess reflecting back, I've always kind of felt like a weed in a wild garden. Felt like not fitting into a formal garden, but finding it fun to be out there where I can explore and wander.